Hi, this is Rick Hatfield reporting for TGW.com. We're here inside the Kingdom at Carlsbad alongside Brian Basil. Brian's the VP of New Product Creation. We're talking about the new 2018 M4 driver.
Right.
If you could point out just three quick things about the M4 versus previous models, what would be the top three?
Yeah, so Rick, I think the biggest thing right here in the new M4 driver is the twist face. Twist face is a whole new look at the face curvature for the drivers to correct shots that are hit off center. And so what traditional bulge and roll is a curvature. Here's a 2017 M2. It's got a curvature this way and a curvature this way, and it's really designed to counteract the gear effect that happens when you hit it off center. The club wants to kind of rotate around the CG when you mishit it.
Right.
And so what we've learned now from really golfers data is that there's common misses, sort of low heel to high toe, and that the way golfers are presenting the club at impact is quite different than the way we would typically set it up for a robot to create this curvature.
Sure.
And so now twist face, you can see this big representation here, is designed to counteract those shots hit off center for the way that golfers are presenting the club.
Okay.
So up in the high toe, where often golfers are closing the face more to their path than they did when they hit it out of the center, balls are ending up left and they're spinning really low.
Right.
We've twisted the face back, we've added a bit of loft, we've opened it a bit, so now those shots on average are going to end up more on the center line. Opposite on the low heel. A lot of people miss it low heel. What happens is it spins too much, ends up to the right. I know that shot. And what we've done is... Exactly. So what we've done is we've twisted it back, we've lowered the loft, and we've closed it a touch to, again, bring those balls back to center and go a lot farther.
It makes perfect sense. Shots hit high on the face are going to spin less. On the toe, they're going to tend to hook.
The toe, they're going to tend to hook.
Yeah, and opposite there. How much correction improvement do you see from twisting the face?
Yeah, great question. So on average, for all the shots, we've looked at tens of thousands of shots, that from high toe to low heel, there's about a 14-yard difference on average of all those shots. Now we've taken that 14-yard difference or dispersion down to 3 yards.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's huge.
Yep, it's a game changer for sure.
It is, exactly. And then on top of that, we've got new hammerhead technology.
This is designed to increase the sweet spot of the drivers, add more ball speed and drop unwanted spin. If dropped the CG and brought it back so the inertia is higher, stability, with that usually comes a higher launch, a higher spin. We want high launch, low spin. And so the hammerhead slot allows us to do that. It also enabled us to make the face much thinner. By making the face thinner, it flexes more and increases that, what we call sweet spot, mm-hmm. so that you get more ball speed on off-center shots.
And you told me the sweet spot on the M4 compared to previous models was how much bigger?
67% larger.
Which is considerable. So the higher MOI or inertia, you call mm-hmm. it, is just the resistance to twisting on off-center hits. But
that's
that right. does tend to produce more spin. So
usually because you have to get the CG back.
Because you got to get the CG back.
Yeah, so part of it is an increased inertia, but the other part is the flexibility, breaking the boundaries like this, like hammerhead, increasing that sweet spot even beyond what inertia is doing.
Excellent.
Yeah.
With the hammerhead technology, have you seen ball speeds increase?
We have seen a bit of a ball speed increase, and especially if you're hitting it off center.
Okay, yeah. And long and straight.
Honestly, every time we make a new driver, our goal is to make it longer and straighter.
Right.
The longer part, we keep inching away, getting as much as we can. The straighter part this year with twist face is a huge step forward.
Excellent. And you still have the tunability in the hosel connector.
On M4, you do have the loft sleeve as well. So it's plus or minus 2 degrees in loft, face angle. So you get some adjustability in M4 driver, but everything else is fixed.
Okay. And just real quick on the M4, tell me about geoacoustic.
Yeah, so geoacoustic was introduced in the original M2, and what we've been able to do different and the new M4 is not only put more weight in the back here, almost twice as much mass in the back, so the inertia's gone up here, mm-hmm. but the geoacoustic portion where we've sunken that in and curved it out, it allows us to control sound. That's the acoustic side
Which
of it.
Is
sound
your feel.
Is feel.
Yeah.
That's what you feel, mm-hmm. right? And secondly, the volume that we free up by just sinking in that sole, we've been able to put back in the M4 in the face. So the face is slightly bigger than the M3. The footprint when you set it down is the same, but the face is slightly larger on the M4, and that's because of the geoacoustic technology.
I love the switch to silver mm-hmm. aesthetics looks good.
Yeah, so
and you've got the new blue and red color scheme.
Definitely, you see a little bit more red in the M4. Look at the top of that; you see colors throughout. And the silver, you know, we spend a lot of time and energy on the contrast between the face and the top of the crown. And we can affect performance with that. Mm. And so though we went away from white, we still have that performance aspect that we really wanted. But there's no doubt that this is the new product, and the M1 and M2 are right. in the past.
Right. Yeah. And I'm sure that that's mainly the design of the crown is probably for effectiveness of the club. But is any of that just alignment enhancement or?
Definitely. Yeah. So in the case of like the M4D type, we can use this line up top, and we actually turn it more open, which most golfers say, well, why would you turn it more open if you're having me try to hit more draw? Well, by turning it more open, we actually close the face, and when you set the club down, it actually still looks square. Hmm. But what you don't pick up is that face is a little bit more closed. And so that's just one example of how we use this as an alignment guide to affect performance.
That's excellent. And I've noticed you've added some aerodynamics to the club this year.
We have, definitely. You see in the carbon fiber here, you see a raised section in the toe. We're trying to keep the airflow as you come down through the bottom of your swing. That's when it's starting to pick up speed. Mm-hmm. We want it to be as fast and as slippery as possible. This raised here allows the airflow to stay attached longer and keep it faster and reduce the drag.
Okay, so a little bit added club head speed equals mm-hmm. ball speed equals more distance.
Again, yep, we're trying to get as much as we can out of the product.
One last quick question. Mm-hmm. We want to differentiate who is the M3 player and who's the M4 player? Who's looking for which club?
Well, I think, you know, now you get a little bit into the psychographics of the golfer. You just want simple, I want to hit it farther, I want to hit it straighter with as much forgiveness. I don't want to personalize it. I don't want to dial it in. The M4 is for you.
Okay.
If you want that added value, whether you're working with an instructor or you really want to optimize your shot, the M3, there is no doubt it's the most adjustable. That's the one you want.
Would you say the M3 is more workable for a player who's looking to flight different shots and
Well, you have an option in the M3 in the 440, which is a slightly smaller head, and that's definitely a little bit more workable. But both are, I would say both are game improvement. They're forgiving heads.
Okay.
You can put the weight all the way forward like we did with Tiger Woods, and all of a sudden you get a little bit more ball speed up for it and a little bit more versatility. Not as stable, not as forgiving as having the weights all the way back. But again, that's the value you get in spending a little bit more on an M3.
Right. Excellent. So just a little more tunability versus high, long, and straight. Well, I think these are fantastic. Brian, thank you for having us.
And thank you.
TGW.com does offer a 30-day mulligan policy, so feel free to try it out. And if you don't absolutely love it, you don't keep it. It's a great product from TaylorMade. I think it's going to be a good year.
Yeah, I know it's going to be a good year.
Yeah, great. Thank you, Brian.